Hello everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about indicators, or more specifically two types of indicator that we use in school: litmus, which comes as litmus paper or litmus indicator solution, or universal indicator. I'm going to focus really more on the universal indicator aspect and talk about pH and what we mean by pH values in relation to universal indicator. So first of all, let's define what an indicator actually is. So we're talking about this word here in the top, the title, indicator. Now an indicator is a substance that will change colour in acids and alkalis. So let's just make a note of that. It is a substance that changes colour. So this is all about colour in acids. So that implies that it's one particular colour potentially in acids and maybe another in an alkali. Now that's certainly the case for litmus. Now litmus indicator is red in acids and blue in alkalis. So we're just going to have a little bit of a scale here. So litmus in a neutral solution or neutral substance has a purple colour. So when a substance has a neutral nature to it, litmus will go purple. If there is an alkali present, litmus will turn blue. So we have an alkali if litmus turns blue. So we're talking about litmus to begin with. We'll come on to the universal indicator in just one moment. So at the moment we're just talking about litmus indicator. Now in the presence of an acid, litmus indicator will go red, a really nice red colour. So this will mean an acid. Now here lies the problem. We can get an acid going red, an alkali turning litmus blue, but that's it. It does not tell us how acidic or how alkaline something is, as in how strong an acid they are, how strong an alkali it is. It literally tells us whether something is an acid or is an alkali, for example. So in school you may use hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid, and with litmus indicator it will turn red, but you wouldn't know whether that's a concentrated strong acid or a dilute one. And that's really crucial, and that's where universal indicator comes in. I'm just going to add a little picture to the screen, and it's this scale of colours right here. See, this would have taken me quite a while to draw out, but we're going to put this scale in place right here. Now, universal indicator has a range of colours that show how weak or strong the acid or alkali is. So universal indicator is what we're going to move on to. So we're going to talk about universal indicator. And we can see we get this range of colours. In fact, we'll grab this and just give ourselves a little bit more room here. So let's talk about this range. Well, right in the middle, we still have this neutral part. So any substance that has a neutral sort of value to it would appear green. Over here we've got regions of what would be a weak alkali, and clearly much stronger up towards the purple end. This represents a strong alkali. And over to the left of this picture we've got regions here that look a sort of yellow orange. These represent weak acid, and towards the red got strong acid here. So you can see as you move along this scale, we're able to get a range of colours instead. So not just with litmus red and blue, acid, alkali, but this colour scale, if you like, with the universal indicator, allows us to go from very dark red all the way through to quite dark purple, bluey purple. We get this range of colour, and it can allow us to show us whether an acid or alkali is particularly strong or weak. So, let's talk about pH. The strength of an acid or alkali is measured by the pH scale. So let's just add that as a note here. So the strength of an acid or alkali is measured by what's called the pH scale. Now, each universal indicator colour is given a number called the pH value. And so universal indicator can tell you the pH of a solution. So we assign a pH value to all of these. So neutral, if we do it on the scale, has a value of 7. So we give a neutral substance a pH value of 7. That tells us that it's neutral. So if we get a universal indicator colour of green, that shade of green, we also say it has a pH of 7, so you can map the two together. So the strength of an acid or alkali is measured by the pH scale, and each universal indicator colour is given a number to fit that scale called the pH value. And if you work your way to the left and right backwards, let's go towards the acid, you can see that as the number decreases, so as the pH value gets lower, we get a stronger acid. And as this pH value rises or increases, we get a stronger alkali. Now, questions often ask how the pH value changes if something becomes more acidic or a stronger alkaline. And it's important to make sure you're using the term increase or decrease correctly. So if we had a stronger acid, the pH value decreases. It gets lower. It gets closer to 1. So that's really crucial to remember. So the pH value goes down as we get more acidic, and the pH value goes up, it goes up towards 14 as it becomes more alkaline. So there we've got a little bit of information just about what is litmus, what is universal indicator, and how we can use pH values to help decide whether an acid or alkali potentially is quite strong or quite weak. And we could give some easy examples of substances with different pH values. So for example, battery acid has a pH value of 1. We're looking at maybe a bee sting around pH 3.5, a little higher. Fizzy drinks often have a pH value around 4.5. Distilled water, about 6. Milk, 6.5. Going up, blood has a pH of around 7.5, maybe a little higher. Egg white has a pH of 9. So we're looking more a sort of weak alkali, all the way up to kitchen surface cleaner that has a pH of about 11, very strong alkaline. So you can map many items on this particular scale. But there we have just a little information about these two types of indicators. An indicator ultimately being a substance that changes colour in an acid or an alkali. Okay, hope all that helps.